Welcome to Power and Counsel with Pastor Sammy, where your life will supernaturally walk on water.
Grace and peace to you, my family. Today's scripture comes from Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 15 through 20. And I'm going to be reading from the NIV version. See, I set before you today life and prosperity, death and destruction. For I command you today to love the Lord your God, to walk in his ways, and to keep his commandments, decrees, and laws. Then you will live and increase. And the Lord your God will bless you in the land you are entering to possess. But if your heart turns away and you are not obedient, and if you are drawn away to bow down to other gods and worship them, I declare to you this day that you will certainly be destroyed. You will not live long in the land you are crossing to Jordan to enter and possess. This day I call heaven and earth as witnesses against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessings and curses. Now choose life, so that you and your children may live, and that you may love the Lord your God. Listen to his voice and hold fast to him. For the Lord is your life, and he will give you many years in the land he swore to give to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The word of the Lord. This reminds me of an old fable story of a buck that was drawn to the water, and as he was drinking the water, he admired his antlers. He just looked at them and admired them. But as he was drinking, he saw his small feet. And he said, I wish I had better looking feet. Not knowing that those feet God gave them to run away from danger. At a certain point, a lion came. He ran, and he ran from that mountain lion. But he was so obsessed with his horns, he started looking up through his horns, thinking his horns could probably fight this mountain lion, and the horns got him caught in the bushes, and the lion ate him, and he was destroyed. Many times we think that our own self-help comes from us, and the worldly advice, we need to remember, it is God who gives us the power to prosper. Let us look unto God who gives us everything and blesses us. And as we come to the table to receive his presence and forgiveness, it is him who blesses us and our family. Let us not look at us or the worldly wisdom, my family. Blessings to you.